Howdy y'all, and welcome to Farming Simulator 15 with a Butcher Man on Willow Tree Farm. Let's get her going. Get started on our day. Walk out of her house, come over to her pickup. Whoop. Climb on the truck. And look at this. Steering wheel. I got my steering wheel mess going. I figured maybe like this might be how I try to start like every video. Is I'll just start with like the truck. I'll start with the pickup and I'll drive it over here and, you know, get to doing whatever it is we're doing. I think we're going to go ahead and start with the harvest just to kind of get that a moving. There's our combine. Where's my field I want to harvest? Let's see. I haven't done anything. You guys haven't noticed. I haven't done anything. Let's see. Either 10 or 13, it looks like. Either one will work. Let's go ahead and do 10, since it looks like it's the closest. Let's back over here. And I think what we'll do is we'll hook the, we will park the truck next to this Sammy. I guess we could have walked over here, but that's okay. It's all good. Just drive the tractor. Oh, I wonder if I could hook. Could I hook the, I couldn't hook that to this. No. That wouldn't even look right, I don't think. I do have a ball hitch, though. Maybe I should try it. Let's go find the trailer. We'll try it really quick. I don't know. It's been so long since I played this game. There's, like, probably a bunch of stuff. Like, the controls, I don't really remember. A lot of the stuff I probably won't remember. Where's the trailer, though? I know I seen it last episode, so bear with me. Let's see. Trailer. You guys, this is right there. The blue tractor. I think the blue tractor's over here somewhere, maybe. Unless I'm mistaken. There it is. Can we hook that to this, or is it going to be weird? It might be weird. This thing may not be dry very well. No, we can't even hook it to it anyway. Alright, never mind. We'll forget that. That was for future reference. We don't need to. If we had a really big truck, maybe. If we had like a normal grain wagon, you know, like the kind with like two axles or whatever, it might work. But like that one, it won't work. Get out. Walk over here and climb up in our tractor. Let's see, where did I say the weights with the rest of the stuff down there, I think. So we should probably go ahead and get the weight on. Go ahead and put it on. We do it. We should be able to do it this way, I think. Yep. Here we go. See if I can get a setup here. I was going to set up before the video, but really, it's farming. I mean, a lot of farming is preparing. Getting prepared to, you know, get your machinery around. Get everything ready to go. Getting all your stuff hooked up and heading out to the field. I don't know why they'd put the trailer next to this little tractor. There we go. Alright, so we want to go to field 10. Which I don't actually know how to get there. Is it right? Let's see if we go. Kind of looks like if we go over here and we take a left. See, so that's field 4. Maybe we want to go down to the house, get on the road. Kind of go that direction, maybe. That kind of looks like the way we need to go. Because that's field 4 and it's on the other side of field 4. Maybe if we go down here, the road, it'll take us around, and then, yeah, field 10 should be right there in front of us. But where is the entrance? Maybe this way? I don't know a lot about the farm. It does seem like a really nice farm. I already got a message. I already got a comment from somebody. Where's the entrance? Maybe it's around the other side. Let's see. Yeah, I already got a comment saying, telling me I should do a let's play. So I think that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna start working on this. I'm gonna be looking for other maps. I can't pull in there. Somebody else's land. Let's see. Let me just kind of do a UE here. Maybe. The traffic go by. There's more traffic. Might have to go down to this road over here. Maybe let's go to the shop turnaround. Once we figure out where all the entrances are, it'll help a lot. We won't have to be doing all this, like looking around and going the wrong direction and all that good stuff. But yeah, I already got a comment. I didn't write down who the comment was from, and I don't have the screen pulled up. I can't tell you who it was, but I actually got two, three comments, something like that. So I'm actually pretty decent. I got home from work. I got on my YouTube. I looked, and I was like, wow, the views are a lot better on Farming Sim than they are on Ark. So, I would like to get into farming, so that's what we're doing. Where is it at? Okay, that's the field. And it wasn't on this side. I don't see a road that goes down the side of it, though. Maybe it's all the way on the other side? Do I need to go all the way around? That'd be a little crazy, but, it's possible. Let me do something right quick. That way I'm not like sitting here looking around forever. How much is this? 4,500. Where's the entrance? Oh, it's r what? Okay, so the entrance. Oh. Okay. I don't own that field though. Well. I guess if that's the way it's got to be, that's the way it's got to be, right? I don't own that field next to it, but apparently we have to drive through it. Okay. Oh, see that? That truck just drove right through the train. Crazy. Crazy. All right, so now we got it figured out where the entrance is. We can finally get over there. It's only taken us like 7 minutes or something like that to decide that we're going to the field or whatever. But I did these things. You guys can watch this. You'll know where the entrance is. You don't have to make the same mistake. But I've gotten, like back when I was doing Farm Sim there for a while, I always got requests from people just, don't cut it out, don't cut it out, just leave it. Now is it that? Not for sure. It looked like there was a road or something. Am I missing something? Oh, nope, there is a road, but it's like through this gate. Weird. Can you back up, please? No? I'm a piece of farm equipment. I need to get through. Please. Thank you. My bad. My apologies. Alright, so we're gonna drive around the field then. But I think we gotta drive through that field over there. It's kind of a crazy way to get in there. I mean, it is a little bit out there, but. Oh, I better slow down. I don't. Okay, this gate opens away from me. That's not too bad. It's just a little crazy having to go through other people's fields and stuff to get to your field. But this one's grass. That one had a road around it, so you're not really driving through crops. We might eventually plow this if we end up buying it. Or when we end up buying it, I should say. We're gonna own all the land. We're gonna be big, big farmers. Alright. Now that we got this over here. What in the world? What just happened there? Did it just kill the crop? That's weird. Is that a mod I have? Maybe? I don't even know. I have no idea. Just jump the fence and run over here. I've never actually seen that before, I don't think. You guys have any explanation as to why it just, like, you know, the crop turned into straw when I drove over it? That'd be great. What was that sound? Let me know. I can't get out here, can I? I don't think so. Come on, Combine. Run over the debris. Go plop a tire or something, then we'll really be in trouble. Well, it's a good thing we took the tractor first, because if we'd have taken this thing first, it would have been a disaster. Sorry, I had a frog in my throat or something. Got all choked up. Alright. I don't want to go real fast in the dirt. Once we get on pavement, we can pick her up. Let's see. It's driving in first person. Drive in the cab. Oh, man. This ain't a real big farm, but I think for single player, it'll definitely pan out real nice, I think. It's got a bunch of good options going in it. We come from that way. Should be able to make it. Oh boy. Can't see the trailer at all. Turn my beacons on. Yeah, I don't know anything about that. The crop turning into straw. Might have to look into that maybe. I don't have drive control in. I don't have drive control, which is normally what kills the crops. Maybe it's just the map? Or maybe it's a different mod I have? I'm not really sure. Alright, buddy. Oh, stop your car. Farm equipment. I know I have, like, the terrain. I think the terrain mod or something like that. That's what allows it to be bumpy and stuff like it is. Oh, there's mud. Lots of mud. That's so cool. I think that's, like, super cool. I mean, compared to the way it used to be, you know, or I guess maybe the way it is without all the mods, it's like, you know, they just add that little bit extra to it. I guess this guy doesn't care that we use his, you know, drive through his field. Kind of the way it's set up, I don't really have a choice. Alright, so I think what we'll do is this header should fit through this gate. Let's see if we can see. If it can't, it's going to be kind of bad. That's kind of questionable. We're going to have to just drive it through there, I think. Not sure it'll actually fit through there. Let's see, and the fence needs to be on my right side so I can actually take it off. Gonna be unfortunate because I'm gonna end up killing some of this crop right here, like I guess. Got that pretty good. Maybe if I kinda do it that a little bit. And then maybe do it like this. Kinda minimize the killing or whatever. Why is it moving? Stop moving trailer. So ridiculous. That's why I hate these header trailers in this game. You know, besides the fact that the headers won't actually stay on the header trailers, you know. Is the fact that... the fact that the header trailers, like, you might park them and then they just kind of move. Is the straw thing on? It's on. And this is wheat. Right on. I wonder if we'll be able to bale that stuff we ran over. Like if it all just turns into straw or whatever on the ground. I don't really know. But I'm going to be... I keep looking for another map. Because I'd like to do probably just like two. Two seems like a good number, I think. At least, like, to get back into it or whatever, I think two seems like a good number. What should we do? Let's put a headland around the back here. But my main website I look on is FSUK. That's where I found this, is FSUK. I look on FSUK, I look on American Eagles modding. Just because, like, American Eagles modding seems like a really, really, like, seems like a pretty good one. I got excited the other day because I was looking, and I found one called Missouri Valleys or something like that. And originally, I'm from Missouri, so I'm just like, yeah, it's going to be amazing. But it wasn't really my thing because the whole map, like, just from the pictures even, the map is flat. You know, if you're a map creator, or you're wanting to be a map creator, and you want people to actually play on your map, you've got to do something more than just a flat map. And, like, that one, I don't understand it, because, honestly, anybody that's ever been to Missouri can tell you that no part of Missouri is flat. So, for him to make what looked like to be a completely flat map, you know, it just doesn't make any sense. And he's just like, oh, you know, these are the Missouri Valleys I grew up in or whatever. And it's like, not that I know of. I mean, if there's some kind of special place in Missouri that's like that flat, I don't know of it. You know, Illinois is flat, Kansas is flat. You know, the states, you know, the two states east and west of Missouri are super flat. But Missouri is like far from it. It seems like our yield is really low, so this probably isn't fertilized in the least. But we'll make the best of it, I think. I'm not going to worry too much about, like, spraying it and all that good stuff. Because, like, I know I did it on the other map that I started messing with, and it wouldn't even let me spray it. And I don't know if that was maybe like a mod thing I have, or... It's on the other side. But I don't want to go through the process of trying to get a fertilizer spreader. Do we have a fertilizer spreader? No, we don't. We have a pickup. We don't have a fertilizer spreader. But I like a pickup, too. Pickups come in handy. You know, driving back and forth from the house to the machinery or whatever. Which normally, like, I'd have a hard, you know, you'd have a higher hand, like, drive the equipment. And then, like, you would drive the truck out here or something like that. So the truck would be out here with you. Da-da-da. All right, let's see. Let's go down the side here. Field might end up being a mess when I'm done with it. Not really sure. Now, I keep seeing some, like, screen... I guess you'd call them screen tearing or glitches or whatever. I don't know if you guys can see it or not. I'm guessing you probably can. I don't know what that is. Maybe, like, I have a corrupted version of Farm Sim or something. Maybe I need to get that fixed. Not really sure. I tried upping my graphics, but if you guys seen at the end of the last episode, I was trying to take a screenshot and the picture was getting messed up, and it was one of the graphics settings. What I might try to do after this episode is uninstall Farm Sim and then reinstall it. I'm gonna get full here. Uninstall it and then reinstall it or whatever, just to see if maybe that can fix it. If you guys know why I'd be having that trouble, then by all means, let me know because I have no idea. I like playing games and I like computers, but there's a lot of stuff I don't know. Let me turn my graphics card fan on. I had it off because I wasn't sure if I'd need it or not, but it looks like I'm gonna need it. Did that not turn it on? Oh yeah, it did. It just didn't refresh the screen. Weird. This go in there? Good, right? Yeah. But yeah, if you guys know why I'm having screen tearing and why I can't turn all my graphics up because of, not being able to take screenshots and that sort of thing, you guys can hit me up. No big deal. I can always take really good advice. You can always take tips and tricks and whatnot, information. If you guys know, it's always good to let somebody else know because that somebody else like me probably doesn't know, and so on and so forth. Come on, Combine. All right, so what we'll do, we'll go ahead and drive top of our straw or not, whatever. Back around this way. We are gonna bale this since we have a baler. And I think, let's just check real quick. This is a 190 and this requires 70. Okay, so the round baler doesn't require hardly anything to pull it. So we should be good on that aspect. We got a bale pickup trailer, whatever, auto pickup trailer. So we should be good as far as getting the bale, like baling the stuff up, picking it up, and selling it for a bit of cash. Man, I keep having to cough a bunch. I know you guys, I keep muting my mic so you don't hear it, but man, I keep getting a frog in my throat or something. Bone in my juice. But we're gonna try to get back into farming. And hopefully I can get that second map going. If I can't, then we'll just play on this one a few times a week. And I'm not gonna guarantee it'll be an everyday thing, 'cause, stuff happens. There's always things that need to be done and whatnot. I don't do a whole lot around the house, not near as much as I should, but I kind of skimp out from time to time and do some other things. I still play Ark, so I haven't been recording any episodes because nobody watches Ark on my channel. So basically now I've just been playing it for fun. I haven't been recording any of it. I have tamed a whole bunch of 150s and not really like a bunch, but I have like four beavers, two or three sabers, a couple of male argies. Let's see. I almost got a female Ankie, female 150 Ankie, but I knocked her out and I did what I always do and I just kind of left them. I tried to put gates around her to protect her, but it was so close to somebody else's base I couldn't do it. And then by the time I went and got the kibble, I came back. There were two Dilos that and she was almost. There was two Dilos attacking her. She was almost dead anyway. So whatever. But it seems like people that watch my channel don't really play Ark or don't really watch Ark or something like that. But Ark's, Ark's just like other games, which I guess it's a lot like Farm Sim already. There's already a lot of people doing YouTube about it, doing YouTube on it, which is fine. I came into YouTube about, kind of late in the game, Because there's a lot of people already doing it, but I basically started doing YouTube when I was prepared to start doing YouTube. And so if it's it is late in the game, and that's just kind of how it works, you know. But I kind of left it for a bit. It's been a few weeks, but you know, I always get motivated to do it more when people leave me comments. You know, people hit my like button and all that stuff. And I got a comment the other. I've gotten several comments asking me when I'm gonna do Farm Sim again, that sort of thing. So, you know, if you guys really enjoy my stuff and you really want to see, you know, lots and lots of Farm Sim, or at least see me keep doing videos on my channel, then you know, it always helps. You know, if you're gonna comment, or if you're gonna like leave a like or whatever, you're gonna subscribe, that sort of thing. It always helps. You know, because it makes me want to do it. And, you know, granted, I do want to do it, but there are times where I don't. So I don't want to, like, I don't want to be doing it and then nobody's watching it. Like, Ark, I've done, like, a bunch of episodes of Ark. And I can't even hardly seem to get any of my episodes over, you know, over 10 views. So that's why Ark's pretty much just going to die on my channel. Unless, of course, for some reason it just picks up. But Ark is very well saturated, and the market is already controlled by a certain, you know, a certain several groups of people, as far as Ark goes. Is that our field? That's our field over there too. That kind of looks like barley, I think. Got 95, but I'm gonna go ahead and fill it up. Might as well, right? But I think what we're gonna be doing is probably like 30 to 45 minutes, something like that. It'll kind of depends on what we're doing. Like today, I would like to get this field harvested. Ooh, gotta pay attention. I would like to get this field harvested so that, you know, we've at least accomplished something today. And it kind of looks like we're gonna be able to. This small combine takes a while, but that's okay. And if we can get it completely harvested today, then tomorrow, then we'll probably be baling it and picking up the bales and selling them, and maybe doing some cultivating. I'm not sure. We'll probably have to just sell everything we take off the field so we can afford to get a some kind of sprayer or fertilizer spreader or something like that. I know. Fertilizer spreader. We can get this one. 14.6, or we can get this sprayer for 29,000. And let's see, 24 meters. That's gonna be a huge pain on this map, though. I definitely don't think I want to get that. We'll probably get that for 14.6 for now. Have any mods? Maybe. I got these few. Like, I don't even know what that is. I need to clean my mods folder, to be honest. I've really thought about going through and just deleting everything. Every mod I have. And just kind of starting from scratch. You know, starting from the beginning. But I think when FS17 comes out, that's what we're gonna do. I will probably delete every mod in my FS15 mods folder, and we will just kind of start over. I need to go back and see if I deleted everything from FS13. It's like, obviously, when the next one comes out, we won't play this one at all. And just so you guys know, if you're watching this and you're like, you know, you might think it's kind of iffy, I've already bought FS17. I've already pre-ordered. Hopefully that means I'll get the tractors that are promised to me, or the tractors that are promised if you pre-order. And I'm kind of debating on whether to do a live stream or if I should do a video. Like, if I just do a video, like, straight away, whatever. We might end up doing like a just doing a live stream. Let's see, turn this. All right. We might end up just doing a live stream, kind of air the, you know, the release. But the only thing is like, you know, are other people going to be doing live streams? Are other people going to be doing something? And the problem with doing a live stream as well is that it's going to take me a little bit to set up, to see if the stream will work. If it doesn't work, I don't know. I'm hoping they've already got it programmed to where, you'll just have to do a couple of things, whatever, and then it'll work. But in case it doesn't, I don't know. If you guys want to see a live stream, put a comment below. If you think I should just plan on doing a live stream on the release of FS17, and then we'll just go from there. And hopefully it kind of corresponds a little better with my work, with me working. Because I know most YouTubers nowadays, they probably have enough subscribers, whatever, they don't work. But I have a regular job. I actually have to get up and go to work. And so I can't just like I can't take off work. I don't have the days to take off work. I can't take off one day, a whole day, just to, live stream FS17 because it came out. It'd be nice if I could, but it doesn't necessarily work like that. So if you guys want to see a live stream though, you can just hit me up. Otherwise, if I don't get like at least a good sizable, like 10 people. I'd like to at least see comments from 10 different people, saying they would like to see a live stream of FS17 the day it comes out. If I don't get 10 people minimum, I'll just do a video. I'll just do like a 30 to 45 minute whatever intro video of us doing things. And since you guys are probably watching this, since I do get views on my farm sim videos, what do you guys think of my intro? What are the, let's get some comments on the intro. I got the intro, I found the template, whatever, and I actually changed the music for the template. So if you guys find one that looks just like that, I did change the music. I added, my own country style of music to it. Some stuff I found off the YouTube library. And I think it kind of fits. I think it'll definitely go in well. I know it's a little low. I kind of wish the music volume was a little higher. I might have to maybe redo it or something, to get the music volume higher. Like, I kind of wonder if I went in and re-rendered it, and raised the volume real high, if it would be higher in the new render. I'm not really sure. I'll have to like test it out. We're gonna go ahead and go dump just because I don't think I can fit another 16 liters of wheat in there. Yeah, those are the questions for today. FS17 live stream or video, and do you like my intro? I mean, that's fairly important, if you ask me. I think that's fairly important. And let's see. I think when we're done harvesting, we're just gonna go take the harvester and store it. And we're not gonna move it to the field. We could move it down to field 13 down there, but I think that'd be kind of nonsense. Leaving it out for the night. Just so we don't have to just so we don't have to put it away, but we're gonna put it away. Preferably, I think ideally I would like to be able to start the video at the house, jump in the truck, drive over, grab some equipment, go out, do some stuff, put the equipment up, take the truck, drive it back and park it to the house, and then we'll be done. It'll all get finished there. Gotta get my screenshot in. I can't really do it after the video. Like, I can't do that screenshot after the video, obviously, because all the stuff will be harvested already. This is a cool looking map though. I'm not really gonna fault him for the field entrances, because field entrances could be whatever they want. Oh, there's a dude fishing, I think. Jump out. Is there actually a dude fishing over here? Are you fishing? You are fishing. Are you catching anything? That is so cool. Huh. We're like swimming. Swimming, swimming, swimming. It's kind of like a sidetrack, but it works. I mean, there's a dude fishing here. I mean, you got to admire the little things in these stuff like this. You know, the guy actually took the time to add a fisherman on the dock at the lake, at the pond. You know, that's a bonus feature. It adds a little bit of something something in there. You did good, buddy. You did good. I know, like, this farming stuff is slow going at first. And I'm still not decided 100% on what we're going to talk about all the time. But, you know, I'm sure I'll think of something. Alright, we got that. We're looking at... I think we're doing pretty good, man. I think we are doing pretty good. Just put in here. That's a pretty nice setup, though. Like, the equipment he gives you to start with. And I don't know 100% that's all of it. It doesn't say anything about, whether you would need the gold edition. I know some people put the gold edition stuff in there. But this one, it was kind of sketchy when I found it. No, that was the other one. Never mind. I need to look through. I don't think we're missing anything. Whoop. What's going on, man? What's going on here? You don't want to drop on there? I don't know. I'm not doing it the right way. What am I at? Right here? Right here, maybe? I hope that works. If it doesn't work, then it's just going to be... Gonna be one of those things, man. Be one of those things. Really don't like header trailers on this game. They need a locking feature. Hear that, Giants? We need a locking feature. And I'm surprised you guys haven't put a locking feature in it yet, but we need a locking feature. From FS17. There needs to be a locking feature for the header trailers. You know, I think that's kind of a big deal. Because, like, on a real header trailer, like a real-life header trailer, you lock the header down on the trailer. In case something crazy happens, like you hit a big bump and the header, like, decides to try to fall off. But on FS, you know, on Farm Sim, there's no locking feature. You know, we're going to drive through this guy's field a little bit because it's a little bumpy over there. And I don't feel like picking the header up if I don't. Looks a little iffy already. Yep, it's going to fall off. Going to fall off. Yep, it's going to fall off. Thank you. Thank you, header. Appreciate it, buddy. Unless I'm just doing it completely wrong. I mean, I don't think I am. I don't think I can drive around with this header on. Might try it, though. If we can, we're just going to leave this. We're going to get rid of this header trailer, I think. And this map isn't going to work very well. Let's see. Drop it. Going to stay on there? Huh? Maybe? Header trailer aren't it. Isn't it already, like, driving in circles without the truck, without the combine hooked onto it? Oh, if it falls off, I'm going to be so frustrated. It's so irritating. We're gonna make it. I've got faith. We're gonna make it. Going to make it. We just keep saying it. It'll come true. As long as we don't meet any crazy traffic. Like that guy. Hey Bernie, what's up, Bernie? Hey Earl, and George and Clyde, all these people driving about. They're all a bunch of crazy guys. You guys might meet them someday. I don't know. They're not real social. I really only know them because I borrowed a cup of sugar from one or two of them, and then like gone by and from another one, and yeah, we're new neighbors. I've got to go ask them to borrow stuff sometimes. Just how it works when you're farming. Sometimes you need a tractor, sometimes you need a cup of sugar. It's hard to say. One of those things that, you just got to play it by ear. So stressful. I'm sure I might be able to just drive through here with the header trailer or the header on, but it seems a little more realistic. And I actually think I want to park our combine over there undercover. I think that might be a little better. Instead of parking it like out in the open. This is a very big investment. Ladies and gents, very big investment. I didn't have my beacons on. Crazy. They were probably laughing at me, seeing how crazy it was. It'd be great if I could like edit the terrain. Like if I went and got a dozer or something, I could like come through and edit a few things, you know? I shut that off. Because I could probably like take out this tree and then put a gate here. Double gate, and then I could just drive the combine through. Probably work, wouldn't it? That's where the field is? No? Oh, I'm not quite there. It's this direction. Yep, here we go. Jumping our Sammy. Oh, sliding around a little bit. Go ahead and shut that gate. We don't want anything getting in there and eating our straw while we're out and about. Probably leave this gate here open just because. Old Paul over there, the owner, told me to leave it open. Said he's got stuff to do. Alright, let me see really quick. We're gonna sell this stuff right now. We don't have to. We got wheat in the back. 1171, 1183. So we need to go to Willow Holt. Where is Willow Holt? Willow Holt is in the south. Need to come out and go right. Yeah. Need to come out of here and go right. Gonna make it? Huh? No? Maybe? Need a little more horsepower in my tractor. A little more kick in the bum. Turn my beacons on. Drive up in the ditch. On the hill. All right. Let's go. We got 20,000 liters. That's not too bad. That's probably definitely not fertilized at all. So we'll have to definitely fertilize it. I need to call Clyde and tell him that field we got terrible. But he'll probably tell us that that's not his fault. Maybe the fertilizer was super expensive last year. You figure he'd have told me that though. If he didn't fertilize it, you figure he would have told me that. That way I wasn't like, expecting a big, like a good yield or whatever, and then just not get it. But, maybe he forgot. It is a possibility. Maybe he forgot. I might call him later and ask him. I'll probably forget to call him and ask him. Then none of us will find out. Oop. Duck. I think I'm stuck. I'm stuck. I think we got a couple of issues here with the I think he might have messed something up here. Yep. It is good and stuck in there. We got a tip point problem. Yep, come out of there. Tractor will come out. I'm gonna have to reset that weight anyway. Come out if I just hit it. Well, I tried to sell it. Nope, it's gonna have to be reset. All of it's gonna get reset. Well, you know, ladies and gents, sometimes it happens, sometimes it doesn't, I don't know. It looks like, though, like, something's going on. Maybe I need to take my terrain mod out, I don't know. Because the tires are, like, sinking in here, like it's supposed to be. Like, you know, like it's a mud pit or something like that. And then it's just getting stuck with the collisions. I don't know. If you guys know, comment. Always comment. If you liked it, hit the like button. If you loved it, subscribe. But I will probably look at the discussion board for this map and see if maybe we can figure this out. And if we can, we'll get it fixed. Maybe I'll just take my terrain mod out or something like that. The terrain and something or other. I might take it out and see if it fixes it. But, yeah, thanks for watching, guys. This is Butcher Man saying good day, y'all, and happy farming.